Welcome friends, welcome to my channel. We had a more discussion on different types of tense. Now in this lecture, we will discuss here this particular perfect continuous tense. Perfect continuous tense for present, past and this one future. Now as we had a discussion on different types of subject, that means always sentences or tense affect by subject, that means person, number and their gender. So we have a different type of subject that already we discussed, and these are the sentences. We can understand these sentences through perfect continuous tense for present. Now we first discuss here present perfect continuous tense for affirmative sentence. Now just understand here the structure, that the structure is here subject plus have, then has, then plus have has plus V3 plus object. Now see the simple structure is here for you. Sorry, V4 form is required here because it is a continuous, means perfect continuous type of tense. Now let's understand, your action is being, is continuous. That what here? That means finished almost, but it has a routine habitual action, you can say. And that you want to say here. तर ही जी एक सतत घडणार आहे. फॉर एक्झाम्पल कशी असेल, तर आपल्याला असं विचारलं गेलं की मी खेळत असतो हे सांगायचं आहे आपल्याला इन मराठी. सेम लाईक मी खेळत असतो, कारण ही गोष्ट पास्ट मध्ये होती, प्रेझेंट मध्येही आहे, फिनिश ही झाली आणि पुढेही खेळणार आहे. दॅट्स इट ओनली. सो जस्ट अंडरस्टँड अफर्मेटिव्ह सेंटेन्स फॉर प्रेझेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्युअस टेन्स. दिस इज युअर स्ट्रक्चर, सब्जेक्ट प्लस हॅव हॅज प्लस बी फोर. सॉरी, हिअर यू मस्ट ऍड वन वर्ड, दॅट इज हॅव हॅज प्लस बी, देन यू कॅन टेक बी फोर प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट. दिस इज युअर सेंटेन्स स्ट्रक्चर, व्हॉट वी कॅन से. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टँड अकॉर्डिंग टू सब्जेक्ट, आय, we, and then you can take you, then you can take they. He is sagli subjects hai, ya subjects nantar tumcha je helping verb yenar hai ki definite have it, have been ready, I have been ready, that's it only. Now you can understand this. Shivay yacha nantar tumchi je dusri subjects hai, he, she and it. Now according to this subject you must use word has, that is you can use has been reading. That's it. Now you just understand what is the difference between these are the subject, this is first person, this is plural first person, this is second person and this one is third person plural, and now all these are the three third person singular subject. So just remember this, this is for your present perfect tense in affirmative point of view, or you can say affirmative sentence in present perfect continuous. Now you just remember here, or you just take the head, that kind of negative sentence in present perfect continuous tense. Now let us understand subject plus have, then has, have has, then you can take not or ent form, then you can take before or object. Same. Now here all the subjects you can take I, we, you and they. After this subject you have, that means we can use only have, or you can use haven't, have not been, then here is your been, then you can use V4 plus object. Now I have not been reading, that's it. Then he, she and it. After this has not been reading, that reading, that's it only. Just keep remember, you can use these type of sentences here. So understand, present perfect continuous tense according to negative type of sentence. Now here we can understand this next type of sentence, which is interrogative sentence. Now, as already we had a discussion on interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences, which is having two types. Interrogative sentence two types. एक मुझे yes no type interrogative और दूसरा wh type interrogative. Next क्या है? ते अपने wh question आए. First of all here you just understand yes no type जो interrogative sentence है कि तुमसे helping verb नहीं चालू होता. मुझे आता तो have क्यों has. त्याच्यानंतर तुमचा subject येतो. त्याच्यानंतर तुमचं been येतं. त्याच्यानंतर before. And then you can use object. Now how it will construct? That means या at point of view ना अपन sentence कैसे construct करो? Let us understand I, we, you, them, they. Simply you take have, but we must be here understanding. That means we are understanding here this particular interrogative sentence. So these are the subjects, but here you must understand. That means you can remember. After that you must place the question mark. So have, I, we, you and they. Have I, then you can use been reading, that after that question mark. So keep remember this thing. Have I been reading? Have we been reading? Have you been reading? Have they been reading? Then has he, she and it been reading? This is your question for third person singular subject. So keep remember, do understand this particular. Now after that we have next type, which is negative type of interrogative sentence in present perfect continuous tense. Now let us understand. We have a structure, and that structure you can carry here. Just understand. Have / has. That means any of these. Then you can take not form or ent, simple short form you can use. Then after that you must use your subject, then use been, then before, then object, then question mark. Now the sentence will have, or you can use have not, then I, we, then you can use you, and then last one, this is they. According to this haven't, or you can use have not, I been reading. This is your negative questions in interrogative sentence, or negative question you can say. Now after that we have a wh question. Now here I must say you, we have number of wh words like who, what, then why, where, then you can use how, which, then whom. Or you can use whom also. So these are the different WH words. You can take the word, that means take the help of this WH word, which is appropriate. That means which is appropriate for your sentence. आता आपली जी situation है, आपल्या जी situation है, किंवा आपल्याला जी action सांगायची आहे, किंवा विचारायचा आहे प्रश्न, तो आपल्या subject नुसार किंवा आपल्या requirement कशा पद्धतीने विचारायचा आहे, तर या WH word पैकी एक appropriate word आपण घेणार आहोत. आणि ह्या राहिलेल्या सब्जेक्ट ना स्ट्रक्चर ना आपण अंडरस्टँड करणार आहोत. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टँड कशा पद्धतीने होईल हे स्ट्रक्चर. लेट मी टेल यू. डब्ल्यू एच वर्ड घेऊया पहिल्यांदा आपण. देन टेक द डब्ल्यू एच वर्ड. देन आफ्टर दॅट हॅव ऑर हॅज. हॅव ऑर हॅज, दिस इज युअर हेल्पिंग वर्ड. देन यू कॅन यूज सब्जेक्ट. देन यू कॅन यूज बीन. देन यू कॅन यूज before, then you can use object, and after that question mark. Now let me tell you, I just say you, tell you one example. Why, then you can use have, I, been reading. That's it only. Now, according to that, you can use all the WH questions. That's it. Then we can discuss next one, which is past. Which is past tense. Past perfect continuous tense. According to this different subject. Now, let us understand first here. In past tense, we have only one thing. That is, let me tell you, subject plus had been plus V4 plus object. Now take the example, I had been reading. This is your affirmative sentence. Now for your negative sentence, subject plus hadn't, or you can take had not. Okay, then after that you can take been, then V4 or object. Then after that object. Now let me tell you, I had, or you can take I hadn't been reading. This is your interrogative negative sentence in past perfect continuous tense. Now next one, which is interrogative. Now here we must understand one interrogative, that is SNO type. Had I been reading? This is your question. Now the structure is for that. Had plus subject plus been plus V4 plus object, then question mark. That's it. Now you can understand negative. You just simply add here negative form, that is not, empty or not. Now let me tell you, had, hadn't, you can use I been reading, hadn't I been reading. This is your negative question, interrogative or negative interrogative. Now WH word, you just remember here WH word. Let me tell you, you just understand how the WH sentences, or you can say WH questions, we can create according to past perfect continuous tense, that is WH word, then plus had, which is our particular helping verb. Then you can use subject, then you can use been, then you can use V4, then object, and after that question mark. Let me tell you why. Then you can use had. Why had I been reading? This is your WH question for past perfect continuous tense. So keep remember, this is for all past perfect and present perfect continuous tense. Now we can just discuss here last one, which is future perfect continuous tense. And future perfect continuous tense, we can understand here according to this type of sentences, affirmative, negative, interrogative, and WH question. Now let us understand for the future perfect continuous tense, subject plus shall, then you can use will, have been, then plus V4 plus object. So lengthy, because it has. Now let us understand I. After I, you can simply use shall and will, we also, and rest of the all subject you can use will. Now let me tell you, I shall have been reading. That you can use only here, I shall have been reading. And after some subject, then you can use we also, then you can use he. Rest of the all subject, he, she, it, they, and you. You can use will, have, been, reading. This is for affirmative sentence in future perfect continuous tense. Now, just understand next one, which is negative sentence in future perfect continuous tense. Now simply you can add here, that is subject plus shall, or you can use shan't. Shall not, which is shan't, which is short form of shall not. Then you can use will or won't, that is short form of will not. Or you can simply add not. Then you can use been. Then you can use before. Then object. Now let me tell you, I shan't that particular have been. You can use have been. I shan't have been reading. This is your negative sentence for this particular set. Future perfect continuous tense. Now you can use rest of the all subject. You won't have been reading. This is for negative sentence. Now next one, which is interrogative sentence, or you can say yes no type interrogative sentence. Now interrogative sentence in yes no type always starts with your helping verb like shall or will. Then shall will, after that you can use your subject, then you can use have been, then you can use before, then you can use object and question mark. Now let me tell you, I shall, actually we can use shall I have been reading. This is the question. Rest of the all cases you can use will you, he, she, it and they. You can use any of these. Will you have been reading? This is your question for future perfect continuous tense and the sentence type, which is interrogative sentence. Now you just understand here WH questions in this particular future perfect continuous tense. Before starting this, I just recommend you, that means I just claim you, you can subscribe my channel and you can share with others if you like all this, okay? And for upcoming notifications we can say, because we have ahead n number of lectures for English language learning. So let us start last, which is WH questions. What I can say here, WH questions for future perfect continuous tense, that which one is remaining. We have number of WH words. Let me tell you, we can take the example here for future tense, which is here. WH word. Then after that, you can use shall or will. Then you can use subject. Then you can use have been. Then after that, before. And after that, object and question mark. Is that so lengthy? Yes, it is lengthy, because in future perfect continuous tense it has n number of that particular helping verbs. Now let me tell you, we can use why shall I have been reading. This is your question for WH question in I shall have been reading. This is the question. Now you can use why will he have been reading. This is your next subject, that is he and I. So keep remember, do more practice for all this, and that these are the some different types of thing what we can say here. Now let me tell you one more thing regarding this whole future tense. deals with shall will in simple future tense. It deals only shall will in simple future continuous tense. It deals with shall will plus be. Okay, in future perfect tense it deals with shall will with have, and future perfect continuous tense shall will with have been. So keep remember this trick. For past, in simple past tense, only the time in simple past tense we can use V2 form. That's it only. In simple, past continuous tense, we can use was where, was which is separated for your singular subject, and where which is separated for plural subject. That's it. Keep remember. And rest of, that means you can say past perfect tense, you can use had and V3. Whole the tense, that means perfect tense, which deal with V3 form of main verb. And according to this, had and V3. That's it. And last one, which is had been V4. In present, you can use simple present tense, that particular V subject plus V1 or V5 and then object. V5 कुठल्या केस मध्ये यूज करायचा आपण तर जे सब्जेक्ट थर्ड पर्सन सिंग्युलर नंबर आहे ही सी इट त्या सब्जेक्टच्या नंतरच तुमचं मेन वर्ब जे V5 म्हणजे मेन वर्बला एस किंवा ईएस प्रिफिक्स सफिक्स लागलेला असेल. दॅट्स इट. देन कंटिन्युअस प्रेझेंट कंटिन्युअस टेन्स मध्ये एम इज आर ही जी सहाय्यकारी क्रियापदे आहेत. एम जे आहे ते पर्टिक्युलर आय साठी आहे. आर जे आहे ते तुमचं रेस्ट ऑफ दी प्लुरल सब्जेक्ट आहे. आणि इज जे आहे दॅट यू कॅन यूज इज विथ थर्ड पर्सन सिंग्युलर सब्जेक्ट. दॅट्स इट. देन लास्ट वन थिंग यू कॅन रिमेंबर फॉर परफेक्ट अँड कंटिन्युअस यू कॅन यूज बोथ द वे हॅव हॅज बट इन परफेक्ट टेन्स यू मस्ट यूज हॅव हॅज एनी ऑफ दिस. यू कॅन यूज हॅज फॉर थर्ड पर्सन सिंग्युलर सब्जेक्ट अँड रेस्ट ऑफ द ऑल सब्जेक्ट यू कॅन यूज दिस पर्टिक्युलर हॅव. ओके. सो आफ्टर दॅट V3 is common. So keep remembering in perfect tense, V3 is common. And last one, which is perfect continuous tense, that already we had a discussion over here. So that's it. Thank you.